Hey guys, welcome back to Maxcar's Stone of War Unification mod for Soulstorm. This time it's gonna be a one-off thing where I'm showing you of a survival game I've played. I know there are quite a lot of survival content already on the YouTube, so Space Battles, like two or three people already doing survival battles, mostly with the unlimited add-on and a million resources, so this is not something I enjoy, so I play with normal resources. I've played this on harder difficulty. I manually set them to be Dark Elder because I find them to be one of the easier factions to play against. As the Legion, I play Steel Legion, and Dark Elder are my AI opponent. There are quite a lot of settings I have on. I have the reinforcement setting, I have the take and hold reinforcement, I have the weather effects, as you can see. I have the fortress add-on, which makes the survival quite a lot easier. I have the special tactics of the survival and the
area ready for construction
outpost stuff enabled. So there's one thing with Steel Legion I want to show off here later, so that's why I chose to do it here, because there's some, let's call it exploit you can do, which to people who have watched all my videos probably know of already, but I wanted to show off what can be done with it, which, because it's pretty hilarious. For the most part, it is kind of standard-ish, capping stuff, building the first defensive. The first attack wave of the enemy is rather weak for the Dark Elder. I played like World Eaters, and they just rush you with like three of the cultist squads. Here it's just one Mandrake, so quite a lot easier. You can have the first upgraded listening post here to defend, starting to build turrets, because turrets with the fortress setting are quite resilient and do quite a hefty amount of damage. So it's one part of my one of my idea what to do here. Second part will take a while to before I can show it. Until then, we can see these mantrakes just looking in the air, moving the head left and right. They are not really looking pretty heavy, so I try to relieve the pain. And the weather is in my favor. Right when I starting to attack them, it's starting to turn a snowstorm, which slows down units quite a lot. That's something I choose to activate, because it's also in the favor of the defender to have the enemy slowed down. In general, that is. Now I'm just building some turrets here, basic defense. Having two soldier squads, three pioneer squads, of course, building the second generator. Yeah. Trying to kill these mandrakes and get the strategic point. I also made sure to get a critical location as soon as possible, because when you have take and hold reinforcements enabled, you want to get the reinforcements pretty much as soon as you can. And you get reinforcements for every wave. This is wave one here. So here we see a few more turrets here. A third generator. Upgrading all my listening posts to tier two, and then fun part is gonna start soon. I can tell you that much, that it's not like you see it on the video links, it's not like 1.5 hour survival replay stuff. It's gonna end a little earlier, but it's a little more fun than to watch AI stuff getting killed for 1 hour and even more. But for now I get the first reinforcements, which are a fully reinforced squad of Rough Riders, even with their sergeant, so they are really nice, especially when defending these advanced tactics here, where the raider is dropping off warrior Silbright as honor guard warriors, which do quite a lot of damage. So I can force melee at least on one squad with them. So that's something. Need to take be careful, because yes, I can force melee common, but also yes, they deal a crap ton of damage back to me. And there in the background you see something. Another HQ bunker. Why do I do that? You will see shortly when it's built, you will see. I mean, you can kind of guess what I'm doing, because the viewer which watched this carefully thought that I haven't taken any specialization yet. Build this, should upgrade this, or yeah, should upgrade this. I also chose the position in the front because A, this thing has a crap ton of HP, and you can upgrade it with heavy bolters and autocannons, so it's kind of a really big tanky turret of sorts, which I find kind of useful. Building new turrets here and there, but my damage is not enough yet to kill these incoming raiders. I mean, they get quite a lot of damage, but yeah. And this is the dangerous part. If you have your Wrath Riders parked here, they are the immediate target of the warriors, so you need to pull them out so that the warriors refocus, and then you can force melee combat again, because if you stay in melee combat you basically die. Now I got my lieutenant for the damage aura. Now I want to show you, if you do this like a social squad and a doctrine and use the other doctrine here, then you can cancel the soldier, and then you have two doctrines active, both doctrines. This messes with the games in several ways. You now have access to all the units, not just one. You can upgrade your vehicle count to beyond 30 because of that, because you get some extra vehicle count for choosing the tanks doctrine. Yeah, that's a lot of there's the cannons now, they should fire once near here, these cannons here. Yeah, so this messes with the game in several ways, more than I have had anticipated before. For now I'm getting tier 2 now. And yeah, what I'm late with is building sentinels. Sentinels are really nice in the early game defenses, because they are quite resilient for tier 1 unit and deal okay damage. These ones, sadly, get dropped off in the front instead of on the back, so they get a chance to get dropped off and force some issues. Starting tier, the wave 3, there are these outposts now, which produce additional waves of enemies. Nothing really to be afraid of, but yeah, more enemies. Yeah, I'm starting to surround this HQ with turrets just because I can. Upgraded now both my HQs with the bolters. Now getting like a ton of upgrades. The infiltration, which is for pioneers and stormtroopers, which is like infantry doctrine, and also starting to get some sentinels in tier 2. They are also useful in tier 2 because they have quite a lot of more HP there, and also yeah, I sent a pioneer here which got slaughtered. A lot of more HP and damage I think is unchanged, but I get like from 600 to 1300 something, like 700 more HP. Quite good. I get my second reinforcement here, which is a squad of soldiers. The squads itself aren't that great in the beginning, but you have to see that they do not count towards your unit cap. So it's basically real bonus units without any cost. Do I get this raider finally? Doesn't look like it. But I have a second sentinel coming out. And now these guys just get melted once they leave the raider. Still need to be a little careful with the rough riders though. But it gets killed while getting out here. The thing is to get all the upgrades is really nice, because there are some upgrades for infantry that is only available for the infantry doctrine, and there are some really nice vehicles that are only present for the tank doctrine. So to have both is really nice. What do I get here? Yeah, I get vehicle and the Salamander Scout tank. Should send a guy here finally. Says that there is a leader, but there is none. But okay, that's fine. See, with one vehicle upgrade, I'm at 21 here. So another option I have enabled is massive battles to have a more vehicle cap. And getting Jarek now. So for now it's pretty straightforward, just killing everything that approaches. These are the special stuff. Do they? Come on, kill them, kill them. And yeah, again they get dropped off, which is sad. I have a Trojan to repair my stuff, the turrets in particular. It's really nice to have an HQ with a bolter on it. I really like it. It's quite expensive. The start, it's like 100 something requisition, but the second upgrade with the auto cannons is like 250 or something. It's like the cost of upgrading a listening post to tier 3. So I'd rather do that and get additional resources for it. Upgraded some to the turrets to the last guns. Have now my thermal plasma generator, which gives me quite the power income. And at some point, I should get you see, I'm floating resources. I should get the tank bunker, which I'm starting right now. More stuff trying to approach. Needs my line of fire. Look at all the bodies here. Add some to it. Talos, that's the vault. Talos gets melted by the last guns. Raider. This time gets killed because I finally have some last guns. Now getting stormtroopers, and my idea is to get the special leaders all to the stormtroopers, because yeah, I just like to do it and get the heavy weapon squads, the support squads, the last cannon squads to my soldiers, because they all get missile launchers, so they have a last cannon to support them. And for the stormtroopers I get all the different leaders, like for example Jarek, normal Colonel. I want to put in Salamander because he's of the leaders, he's the more squishy one. And then you get another hero unit for infantry specialization, which name I forgot of. be honest, I don't even know the abilities they have. But yeah, this one probably, yeah. Riot Jacobus. Yeah, I get now another soldier squad. So I have a second soldier squad for free. Yeah, they all get the less cannons and missile launchers, so I'm pretty well defended against vehicles right now. There he is. And gets attached to the stormtroopers. Yeah, the stormtroopers aren't infiltrated if you add a leader, but still. I like it. Getting more upgrades here, the heavy, the tier 3 now. So. Now it's just a big line of infantry standing here, shooting down the hill, killing everything. So not so special yet, but hitting tier 4 is gonna be interesting, I tell you that. It's not gonna be long until then. Upgrading my listening post to the second to add more health and income for me, as well as defensive power. Tier 3 is now almost finished, so I can get artillery. And who doesn't like artillery?
I am empowered to deliver just
a good share. Another commissar here to add to my third stormtrooper squad. This one. I have now hero models on all my squads now. There's some more Dark Elder trying to approach. Approaching on the Hill of Death. Last cannon and last gunfire here. Melting everything. Even the new Elder units just walk in and die. Don't even know what they're called. Left side as well. Talos will be melted. There we have the first Basilisk. The Basilisk has an unbelievable attack range for the Sea Legion. It's like from here it stands, or I move it here and it can shoot like until here. So it's like really, really big range on that. Has no special ammunition rounds though, like the IG would have, does have. These guys standing out of my range for some reason. But I think I moved them forward a bit. Now getting the second Basilisk here, and I should also get the tank ace at some point, because it's don't call it free, but it's a Lehman Russ basically that is not poor guys, it is not counted in your Lehman Russ cap. You have a cap of 2 Lehman Russ, but if you this tank ace is a hero Lehman Russ, you could say, which is by itself limited by 1. I'm getting a lot more upgrades here for my stormtroopers and my infantry and everything. And yeah, should at some point get to tier 4. More bodies to pile up here. But I guess these edgy elves like being shot to pieces, I don't know. What's your problem? Yeah, well, I have 6 rockets added to him. Here I'm getting the squad cap increases, and you will see it's getting quite ridiculous. Here we have the Vanquisher Lehman Russ, the hero tank for the Legion. Tier 3? No. Tier 2.5, right? Tier 2.5, yeah, you need tier 2 and the tank bunker for it. Now tier 4 is starting, getting different upgrades here. You can also get upgrades for vehicles depending on your doctrine. Now you can get all the different upgrades. because you have all the doctrines. That's one of the most broken things about it.
Taking fire.
Jesus. And here is our first stormtrooper, Honor Guard, or bonus. They have some interesting properties. They have access to a grenade launcher, which a normal hand flamer, which a normal stormtrooper does not. Flamer they get, but no grenade launchers. Don't know why I would give them grenade launchers, to be honest, because plasma guns or melter guns are way better. I forget them for quite a bit here. And they also have a little bug attached to it. Can you please run for your safety? Max, can you please turn these guys away? Thanks. Now getting the autocannon add-ons for my HQs as well. Now they're running away, so I have now 4 stormtroopers instead of 3, which is awesome. Stormtroopers are really good. I think I give them all plasma guns, so they are more infantry killing stuff, and I give them, to improve on the infantry killing stuff, a heavy bolter support squad at some point. And do we see the bug yet? No. You will see the bug soonish. I think when they get the first weapon upgrade. Yeah, because they have there are different unit icons depending on what weapon they have, what special weapon they have. And for these stormtroopers, this icon is not how should I say, in the right place, adjusted or selected for it, so it's this pink color here. So don't call me out on that one. What do we get here? Improved tank armor, that's what I told you about. So now we're just standing here having like a million stormtroopers, a vanquisher, but now we also have this airstrip. And now things get interesting, because the devs didn't thought of the idea of having both doctrines. Now can get the Stormblade and the other Baneblade Rewind, so both, because they're all limited to one by itself, not by and both. And for the Lehman Russ, it's a little janky as well. If you build an in a certain order, you can get like 4 Lehman Russ out instead of 2. Plus one for the tank ace. I think at least you can get 3 plus the tank ace, so it's 4 in total. I even built the destroyers, but at some point I don't use them. Now we have the Lehman Russ Conqueror Commissar in it. That's something you can do. Now we have a detecting Lehman Russ Conqueror. And yeah, it's awesome. I really like that I can build a more ultimate unit and Lehman Russ without the ultimate add-on, because I'm not a big fan of adding something more to this mod, but it's nice to have this little, what should I call it, abuse, you could say. Yeah, destroyer is up, but not for long, because I need the cap at some point. The cap. The enemy base is quite loaded with stuff, you can see here. And there we have it. Stormblade getting an exterminator now. And there is the point where I notice, wait a second, I can build more Lehman Russ. I have 1 Lehman Russ out and build more. Conqueror is another one of these, and Exterminator for the tank doctrine, and there's the Storm Sword. Stormblade, Storm Sword.
Heresy must
and yeah, and at some point I noticed that I can build Demon Ross here as well, so now my problem is population. But you see, it's 13 more pop cap on these settings. Normal settings, it's gonna be like 6 or something. You're over the squad cap because of the abuse. So hilarious what you can do with it. I'm gonna look into it if there it's possible for more factions that have this specialization mechanic. And funny thing is, I also get a Stormblade reinforcement. So I now have two Stormblades and getting a Storm Sword, having three ultimate vehicles here. Good night, ma'am. I think it's the ma'am, right? Yes. Look at the beauty. I don't know if it's a girl or not. What are you doing here? Now I have the storm blade, the storm sword, getting even another Lehman Russ. So, how much Lehman Russ do I have? One, two.
Marvel of the Adeptus Mechanicus.
Only two? It's boring, right? I killed my sentinels to get some more vehicles, some more supply. Free. These hounds. Do you think they can kill me? Now the big problem, that the final boss of this game is the pathing. To get my big vehicles out, it's gonna be interesting. I got my storm blade out here, but my storm sword is stuck with the destroyer. Also my tank ace and Limeras Conqueror is also stuck. Here I have another Conqueror inside. Yeah, a Conqueror. So the final boss is here, as I tell you, it's the pathing here. Another Conqueror, so we have now two Conquerors.
Our weaponry is an unyielding hammer.
And I will build more Humorous. I can build more Humorous. I have two now. With the tank ace, I have three. And there are gonna be more. For now, I'm supply blocked, but I'm gonna kill these destroyers and build one or two more Humorous. There, I destroyed them, and now I can build more. Come on, Max. Past Max, do it. Now I'm moving out to destroy these outposts. There we have it, an exterminator and an executioner. So I have almost all the variants. The only thing I'm missing I think is a standard human Rosna, or maybe one of the tank specialization human Ross. Now I have here my heavy cavalry, you could say. My tank force moving out. That's how I like to play the IG factions. Infantry stays behind and tank mobility is used to attack. And they just melt everything they see. At some point I thought I can maybe build it a little differently to have more Lehman Russ. So you see me at some point killing a Lehman Russ or two. Yeah, I think I killed this one and wanted to rebuild it as a standard Lehman Russ. So I think I killed two Lehman Russ and tried to rebuild them, but it only works if you build the Lehman Russ of the infantry specialization first. That's something I realized right now. So I need to kill one of these as well. Then I can rebuild it. I think rebuild it momentarily. Yeah, Demon Ross Battle Tank and Exterminator. I think I do it in that order. Conqueror. Yeah, no, I stick to what I had earlier. Yeah. One, two, five Demon Ross. So for now, I killed the one. Killed the one outpost. Now I'm just leaving these guys here, fighting whatever comes close to them, and making sure that I try to get some units on the other flank to kill the other outpost. Probably the Stormblade by itself would be enough, with a Trojan repair on it maybe.
Powered up. Waiting
order. We have another exterminator here, getting a commissar in it. Come on, I don't know if the Commissar is shooting its pistol when it's inside. I would like it if it would be like that. We have now the big reinforcement wave. Tier 4 reinforcement. It's soldiers, Wrath Riders, Stormtroopers, and a freaking another tank. My 6th Lehman Russ tank. This is so awesome. Look at these guys. All fired up. I tried to get one guy through here, but he got stuck, of course. These guys are just standing here for now. Shooting everything they see. Don't know if I'm moving them back at some point. Not sure. Now that I have the other Lehman Russ here, I'm totally able to just move out with these two and kill this second outpost. And we are slowly but surely reaching the point where I thought to myself, yeah, it's wave 7. Do I really want to play this to wave 10? And just sit here standing around with my superior weapons and numbers. At some point I decided that 3 relic units and 6 Lehman Russ is quite a good number to attack the enemy. There are only 3 here, where are the others? Ah, they are stuck here. So now I'm killing the next outpost here. Is the last one. There's always 2 outposts, one's creating one tier 3 unit each. These were the witches. On the other side it was the war beasts, I think. This is killed now. So I'm now deciding back and forth, should I attack, what do I do with my units here. Are the different tanks moving up. I'm trying to get the Commissar on the other side to get into a normal Lehman Russ, so that we have detection on both sides. I like it. Jeez. Look at this. So much destruction. It's all the vanilla game. The vanilla, how should I call it, not the vanilla game, the vanilla unification, no add-ons. It's just what's possible with abuse here. Clearly not intended, but clearly very funny. As I should talk about, is this viable in multiplayer? In high level multiplayer, probably not, because you need 2 HQs to do it, and another HQ costs 700 requisition, 150 power. If you build one of these in the game before you choose a specialization, you basically sink a whole lot of resources in something that will pay off late game. So by that point you will probably be behind in unit count, in tech or resources, or probably more than one of these. So I think it is maybe viable in a free-for-all when you get not pressured, or in a big team game when you're like one of 4 guys and the others take care of the enemies while you prepare this abuse. So in, let's say, standard 1-on-1 PvP, I don't think this has any way to be a thing. If you try to do it, you have probably lost, or if you win with it, you could have probably win with any other strategy you had, because your enemy was way worse than you. So here we have the tank party standing here attacking the enemy base. We have 2 more tanks on the other side also attacking. And at some point we will trigger the defense wave, but that's okay. We have tanks. And at some point I think I also move my infantry, so we have the whole might. Is this the defense wave here? It really much looks like it. Radar. I think Talos, Hemolucus. Maybe they just got stuck here because just... Yeah, just look at it. So for now I'm just attacking the buildings of the Dark Elder here. Killing his listening posts, his production facilities, his Shadowgate will fall in a second or two. Just need to get a shot of these tanks here. This is awesome. Why is this one tank not shooting this guy? And now it's starting to shoot. Awesome. How many Lima Rust do you have? I take them all. Nice. Now I decide to attack with my infantry as well because I think that I noticed that there will be an enemy attack at some point. Kill this fortress in the front. And he uses one of its global abilities, and I think once this fortress is taken down, hell breaks free. Because these guys aren't stuck anymore. They'll probably try to kill me. Or maybe one of the defense stuff will now start to emerge. No, now these guys are probably free at some point, and then, yeah, shit drops the deck. Yeah, now they start moving, and when one goes through it, the second one goes through, and so on and so forth. Here's also a Revenger, which is the tank equivalent for Dark Elder here. They are still stuck, I think. Now the defense wave, or not, maybe it's the next wave, I'm not sure. That's the defense wave. Three Dies of Destruction. More than one Dies of Destruction, though. I had attacked the fortress too much, and now hell breaks free. I have quite a lot of stuff here. I get a big shot of it. I think this one is a good one.
Our purpose is renewed. Fall back to secondary position.
Hit at some point I was like, yeah, can I kill this all, or can I just focus the enemy HQ? Because you win when you kill the enemy HQ, no matter how much units they have remaining. I'm not sure, I probably could have killed all this Dies of Destruction and Revengers and everything, but at some point I wasn't so sure, so I at some point started to kill the Cabal Fortress, and this, because at this point I lost my second relic unit, only have my free relic unit here, so... And also they had a freaking Soulstorm right in the middle of me, Jesus. So I need to finish this before the defense wave is killing me. And there we go. So guys, this was a one-off game of me playing the AI. If you liked it, you can tell me if you liked it and if you want to see one of these games every now and then. Actually, I need to play some survival to get for my tech trees, to get every units you can get, because you can get extra units that you're not able to in the campaign for it, like for Chaos Marines you can get Predators and another, the big red demon guy, I forgot the name of. And yeah, so that's something you can't get a second one in the campaign, so I need to look if they have some different weapons and stuff, as the stormtroopers here, they have different weapons, so that's something I want to know and have added in my tech trees. So probably playing some survival games every now and then, and saving the replays if you guys want to see more survival. If not, and we will see more, you will see more PvP games. For now, yeah, it's gonna be some more PvP games before I'm even considering mixing in some more survival or stuff. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.